people, this is Khushi Zawar and you're welcome here. So a few days back, I asked you guys a question on my Instagram that what type of video you want to see next on my YouTube channel. So the topic I choose from those comments is how to make aesthetic pictures for your Instagram. And also it can be named as how to take yourself portraits or how to shoot alone or just how to take beautiful pictures. Okay, I had some ideas in my mind and I thought why not to present it to you all, and even you can do the same if you like it. And also I want you to know that in this video we'll start clicking from basic pictures to advanced level pictures, and also we'll edit our pictures a little to give the real essence of the creativity. Oh yes, let's roll into the video. I am ready. Okay, so I have just applied some eyeliner and a lip balm. Keep your makeup very mild for the first one and wear something vibrant. I wore this orange fur sweater. It looks very vibrant in the picture, so I wore this. So the first one, the first picture we'll do is known as scratch. You know why in upcoming minutes. And also I have this Bluetooth remote which is very handy, and you just need to connect this remote to your mobile phone by Bluetooth, and just on one click it clicks picture. So definitely I'll recommend you all, and yes, it is better than mobile timer. And also if you are more into self portraits or home photography, this is a must buy. For this one, sit in front of a background which is very vibrant in colors or which is very messy. I chose a white background because I'll be editing the background in the final picture. So even you can do that. You need to pose in very abstract and very cute poses. You can even choose any of the poses from these. So coming to the second one, I wanted to keep the same color for the picture, and also this one is known as no face picture. So you have to place the camera on the ground. I'll just set my camera and show you how the angle looks. Keep your camera on worm eye level. You can just pose while lifting up your knees, or you can stand and pose. Just cover your face with your hands. And also a pro tip, let sky be seen. Blue colors give a very vibrant and attractive look to your pictures. So because of the sunlight, you can't actually see how you're posing. The screen reflects a lot. But according to me, I guess the pictures will be pretty good. Let's see. So the one we're doing now is known as leaves. So for this one, I just changed to a black top. It is a plain black top shimmery. And also I applied lipstick. So you'll have to gather a few leaves for this one. So let's go and pluck out some leaves.
Again, place your camera at worm eye level, and the only job you need to do is to throw leaves on camera and see how pretty the pictures come out to be.
So for the next one, you need to have some artificial flowers. So I've got this string of artificial flower for me, and I'll just show you how the angle should be.
Play with those flower strings. It gives a really, really very beautiful picture. And just try various poses, different poses. I've tried these poses and covered half of my face. Look very pretty.
So you just have to play with flowers for the next one. I just wore this Netka Apu coat. I just had it. And I bought a pair, not a pair, I just bought a string of white flowers. And in this picture, you have to, sit in front of a background which is white. I had this curtains and I thought it will look really cute. So yes, let's start.
I chose white color as my theme because white gives a very dreamy effect. So the curtains, the upper court flowers are in white, and also you'll be astonished to see what the outcome is. I just tried very vague poses with the flowers, and look.
So the next picture we'll create is using a frame. For this, I changed my t-shirt to a white graphic tee, and you'll require frames. So I have this frame and this frame. I'll show you how to do it.
Place the frame anywhere and act as if you're looking at your own picture in the frame. We'll edit that, but also keep changing the angles of your frame and angles of your face. Look what suits your face, and also look what is looking good in the pictures. So I've tried out some angles, even you can do that. I've also tried some poses with a frame which is very big in size, so I can fit the bigger images in it.
So we are done with this one, but for this you'll have to know a little bit of editing. It is not actually very tough, but it is just a trick, okay? So do let me know in comment section if you want a video on how I edit my pictures. And yes. So for this one, you require a brush, and also I've applied a little eyeshadow on my eyes, because this one majorly focuses on your eyes, so you know they should look a little attractive.
So just swipe the brush from your face as if it is looking that you're coloring your eyes. We'll edit the entire picture in black and white, and the portion of your eyes will be seen uncolored, so that it gives a very vibrant look to your face and it majorly focuses on your eyes.
So in the next one, I'm keeping this eye makeup, and for this one you just need a Polaroid. So this is a Polaroid, a single frame, and just pose.
I lost the clip, but you just have to place Polaroids covering your eyes and lips.
The next one is known as illusion. Here we'll create some illusion with very random and abstract poses. The final outcome looks really very cool. So I'll show you how to do that, and also this requires a little bit amount of editing. So again,
with this you just have to move here and there and give very vague and confused poses. As you can see, I have posed from both the sides so I can edit and create some illusion out of my body posture.
So the one we are doing now is known as a chewing gum. Actually, I can't blow a chewing gum. So I've got a balloon. This is a trick, not the something that I've created by my own mind. I saw these pictures a lot and I thought they look really cute, so I wanted to include this. And also for the people who can't blow, the bubble gum, you can use a balloon for this. So just stretch the balloon and blow the balloon to the size of a chewing gum. Put a knot. And yes, the chewing gum is ready. And also, apart from chewing gum, a corner is necessary. So I took this corner of my room because I can see two different textures when I'm this side. And I think it looks good. So yes, let's go ahead. And also make sure your balloon size is not very big. Mine is just this much, but it looks big. So just make sure it is not very big so that it doesn't look fake.
Just pose now and mention in the comments which is your favorite style among all these, and let me know what type of video you want to see next on my channel.
So here we come to the last one. For this one,
you need to wear a skirt, or you can also make a skirt using colorful dupattas that looks very vibrant and beautiful. And also you need to have some flowers, and again you have to place the camera at the berm eye level. After placing the camera, just stand straight and pose with the beauty of flowers and elegancy of skirt, and you know the pictures will look so fabulous. You'll be very amazed to see the outcomes of these pictures. These are really, really very beautiful pictures. So this was all for today. Do let me know what do you think about these creative pictures. According to me, this was a lot of work and a lot of mind is used in making such pictures, and also it is not very easy. So you have to retake it many times. And if you like it, please try to create yours in this, and also don't forget to tag me. And if you have any suggestions for the next video, or you want to see me doing any other thing, so please do let me know it in the comment section. Bye!